So hello everyone, in this video I'll be covering the user interface of the Grasshopper. So let's open up the Rhino 6 first. In the last videos I have covered the introduction to the Grasshopper and installation of Grasshopper and its plugins. So first let's open up the Grasshopper. So the thing is, the Grasshopper always works on top of the Rhino. So you can see so we have to work on both of them at the same time. So one of the first thing that we have to do is to align them so we can work on both of them at the same time. So to do that, I click on the top of the title bar in Rhino 6 and drag it to the top, and you can see both of them are side by side. So if I'm doing any changes over here, they will be visible in the Rhino 6. So I maximize it. So what I'll do here, will be useful here. So let's see the user interface of the Grasshopper. So first thing you will see when you open it, you will see some files here. So these files, those little rectangles actually represent the last recent opened files. So in the last video we have covered this particular video on the tower, and you can see it is visible here. And one more thing, even if you have to work on the full screen on the Rhino, and so what you can do, you can double click on Grasshopper and it will minimize in the level of title bar. So this is a very good option if you have to work on the Rhino. And let's go next. And the next thing you will so come back to the user interface. So this particular area is the menu bar where file, edit, view, display, solution and help. You are seeing the option in the file menu. You will see things like new document, or you have to open a particular document. Here you will see the recent files, and one of the things that you should must look for is the special folder. We can see the components folder, and in the components folder you will find the plugins that you have installed, and the auto save folder. It is also important. In the edit you will see the general options like cut and copy and the paste. The next one is the view. So this particular area is actually the menu bar, and this is the components palette, and this is this particular area where we will be putting our elements. This is this area is called canvas, and these are called the canvas toolbar. So you can hide them using the view. If you want to hide the canvas toolbar, you just go to the view and click on the camera. It's hidden. When you can hide these component tabs and it's hidden, but we don't want to do that, of course. So let's bring them back canvas toolbar. And in the display option, there are many options like the wireframe preview, and these are also available here, and canvas widget, which I will cover later in this video. Solution is used when you have made a particular algorithm and you want to compute. So this is where you go. And help, the if you're starting at the very basics, I would encourage you to go through the tutorial files. It has some already made files. You should go through them. Second is the Grasshopper support. If you click on this link, it will open up the Grasshopper community, where you will see various discussions on the various topics. The Grasshopper community is very robust. If you are working on any advanced project or even the simple, if you had to ask something, go over there, you will find your answers. So let's go next. And the next one is the component palette that you are here seeing. Component palettes, and let's see the first one, the parameter tab. It even you hover over it, you see information like it says this tab contains 4 panels and 77 components. So the Grasshopper actually contains a lot of components. It's it's not possible to remember all of them, but there's a way. Like if you don't know what this a particular component, just hover the cursor over it and it will show. Like at this time it's saying it's a curve and it contains a collection of generic curve, and it's simple. Even this multiplication, it's saying mathematical multiplication. So if you don't know what a particular component does, you just hover your mouse over to that, it will tell you. And there's a thing like I drop a circle over here and the circular arc. So you know, if you can look closer, circle and curve are closer, so the most recent component that you have used will be visible in this particular tab. It will keep on changing more easily. So let's, next is the canvas toolbar. This particular place here, if you click, it will open up the Grasshopper file. It is for the saving purpose. Next one is for zoom in and zoom out. It's for that purpose only. And this is for the, if you want to focus on a particular area of the, basically when you work on the advanced projects, let me put some components so that I can explain you. When you will work on advanced projects, then you will have you will covering a lot of area in this canvas, so you will have to go to the particular areas because as you will need in them. So let's focus on the top left corner. So if we cover here, if you come over, you can see, if you want to come over upper left, you can easily come over here, or you know, the lower left, it will take you here. The next one is quite important. So another thing, if you want to pan over here in this canvas area, just press right click and drag. You will be easily able to pan in this area. So if you important thing is, like, if you have another important thing is, just suppose if you have a particular set of components which are here, and let's name them group one. Just click on it and name it and press click. Okay, so this is the group one, and let's go to the second one and click here. Let's say it is a group two. Press okay. And the third one, let's name this one group three. So the flexibility that this provide to us is switching between those group, like press group one, you are there, group two and group three. So these are some very important tools. And next one is sketch object. If you want to sketch something, press okay if you're done, otherwise cancel. So there are still more things. Suppose you have a particular set of group of components and you want to actually group them. So what you can do is just consider, like, these particular set of components are the group one and this is a group two, and you want to actually, you know, contain them. If you want to group this particular number of components, just left click, drag and press Ctrl G, and they will be grouped. Same thing for these, left click select and Ctrl G, there's a group. And you know, there's a visibility option. If you click on the blob outline, it will change the way it is grouping them, and it looks nice anyway. And another thing, you can, you know, subgroup these, like if you want to contain them in a particular group, just select them and press Ctrl G. There's a rectangular, and you want to convert them into blob outline, and they're done. So both of them are in the same. And you know, another thing, so let's go ahead for the next things. Let's open up the file, open document. So we have again our tower file that we have covered in the last video. So let's go for these options. Here what you can choose, let's go for these options in canvas toolbars. And if you don't want to see these the geometry, click on this, it will hide the geometry. If you want to see them in wireframe, click on this, or the intersected view, you can go for here. So next one is for hiding. And if you are considered, and this is for controlling the mesh quality. So in the end, there's one more thing. Let's go for, and yes, if you, there's a if you click on the wheel of your mouse button, then you will see a radial menu over here. What the radial menu does, it gives you the recent option that you have selected, and it is very useful, you know, when you are to work fast on your projects. And there's one more thing is left, important thing I would say. So let's, and you know, another thing, if you have to, let's suppose you have to input this particular component over here, and suppose you need a particular space here, so just, you know, select these, press alt and drag, and you will see there's a space in between, so you can add more components. It gives a flexibility if you have to add more components. So let's go for next, and if we go to the display, you will go for the canvas widgets. These all widgets are actually very important. The first one is the compass. Compass is here in the right bottom corner. What it gives, it gives a direction where is your these particular set of algorithms are. Let me pan the surface. You will see as I'm changing, moving the screen, this particular arrow actually points out where are the codes. So this does the work, and you can hide it by, you know, double click, single click on display widgets, and compass it gets widget. So the next one is the align tool. If you activate it, then you will find something like this. Just select them, and you will see there's an option. Options like these are the align tools. If you click on this, distribute objects horizontally, so it have distributed these in horizontal way, or if you want them evenly distributed in vertical way, just click on it, or left or right, whatever way you want. Press Ctrl Z to undo. So align, and the next one is the Marco tool. Marco tool is actually very important. Marco tool is visible on the left bottom corner here. This tool predicts what you will be needing next. So according to this tool, I need the line tool. So it does basically a prediction like what you will be needing next. So it's kind of an important one. The next widget is profiler. Profiler is helps if you are working on a, you know, big projects. It actually, you know, shows how much time a particular component is taking, 21 milliseconds, and if you look at it, this one taking 89 milliseconds. It is the profiler. If you click on it, it gets high, it gets hidden. And next one is message balloons. Message balloons, you can see them. Let me show you. Yes, this is a message balloon. You can hide it, visible it. So what it does, it shows the current condition. So it says the floating parameter pin failed to collect data. It actually shows what is happening actually inside the particular component. So it is, so these canvas widgets actually help us, you know, navigating in the canvas area and looking at our algorithm.